Hello, and welcome to Potential and Kinetic Energy, Part 1, Paper Airplane Launcher. My name is Brian Diaz, and I am my brother's keeper peer advocate with LA County Library. In this series, I will be demonstrating not one, not two, definitely not three, but four, count them, four science do-it-yourself activities to show the relationship between potential and kinetic energy and why they are important. An example of potential energy is when an archer pulls back on their bow and holds that position. Once the archer lets go and releases the arrow, the potential energy has been converted into kinetic energy. The stored energy is now let loose, which is another way of exampling how kinetic energy works. You can think of potential and kinetic energy as a cause and effect relationship, where potential energy is the cause and kinetic energy is the effect. We could get more technical and find out the exact amount of energy being outputted based off the mass, angles, and other factors. The main reason of these examples is to help show the relationship between potential and kinetic energy. The materials you will be needing for this activity are a sheet of paper, stapler, pencil or popsicle stick, small paper clip, and a rubber band. Grab the sheet of paper, fold it vertically, then open it back up. We should be left with a crease running vertically down the sheet of paper. Fold the top right and left corners towards the middle crease. If done correctly, both top corners should be meeting in the middle of the paper. Fold the right and left sides overlapping the previous folds towards the middle crease. If done correctly, both sides should meet in the middle once more. Only this time, it should look narrower. Try your best to keep both sides even, as it would help the paper airplane become more aerodynamic. Always use the middle crease as a guide to how far down you should fold, as well as how far left or right you should fold it. Fold the paper in half with the folds facing inside. Then fold one half outwards towards the middle crease. Fold the other half outwards towards the middle crease. Our paper airplane is now complete, so let's put it aside for now. Grab the pencil or popsicle stick and rubber band. Wrap the rubber band around the popsicle stick to create a knot. You want to make a knot towards a half an inch away from one end of the popsicle stick or pencil. To secure the rubber band, you can pull the rubber band as tight as possible around the popsicle stick or pencil. The best way to make the knot is to use one hand to keep the knot still and the other to pull back on the rubber band. Now, let's put this aside and grab our paper clip. Create a 90 degree with the end of the paper clip. Next, grab our paper airplane and insert the end of the paper clip in between the middle crease of the paper airplane. The paper clip should be inserted towards the nose of the airplane. If done correctly, the rest of the paper clip should be facing the back end of the paper airplane. Staple the portion of the paper clip that lays inside the airplane. This will secure it in place and prevent it from coming off. Be careful with the open paper clip side sticking underneath of the paper airplane, as that is going to be the main function of how we can hook our paper airplane to launch away. Grab the popsicle stick and rubber band attached to the paper airplane. Insert the paper clip to the end of the open loop of the rubber band. Pull back until your elbow is aligned with your back. This angle should be enough potential energy to give our paper airplane the launch it needs. Then release. As we pull back on our rubber band, we are creating potential energy. Once we release the paper airplane, we have converted our potential energy into kinetic energy. I recommend using your launcher outside or in an open space away from other people. We hope you have enjoyed Potential and Kinetic Energy Paper Airplane Launcher. In our next video, I will be showing you how to make a party popper and a cotton ball launcher. Click the link in the description box for our survey and upcoming programs. It would be very helpful if you could give us your feedback in our survey. This helps us figure out what other type of programming we can offer you all. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell for easy access to new videos. Bye for now.